So hello everyone, today I have with me Dr. Mahendra Dore, the principal of Shivaji Science College, Nagpur, on our platform Thoughts on Education by College Duniya. A warm welcome to you, sir.
Thank you, Harsh. Good morning.
Good morning, sir. So coming to the first question, sir, you have held key positions at Education Institute throughout your professional career. What are the key factors that help you keep in connect with the education sector?
Since childhood, I was a brilliant student, and as being a son of a primary teacher, the environment at my home was as of only of education field. Many visitors which used to visit our house were from teaching fraternity, and since childhood I was impressed with this profession, because my father's friends were all from teaching fraternity, where they were all teachers, and as it was imbibed in our mind since childhood that this teaching profession is a noble profession amongst all professions. And I, as far as I am concerned, I feel that this is the only profession which gets directly connected with the society. Every year we get new students to work with, and year by year we can have impact of various types of students, and we can get connected with them. And this is the profession which help contribute in the nation building also. That is what I feel.
The mixture of the upbringing in your family, as well as the giving, the sense of giving back to the society, is what drives you, I feel.
Exactly.
So coming to the next question, being the principal of Shivaji Science College, what is your philosophy of leadership and how would you describe your leadership style?
As far as leadership is concerned, any institution is not solely dependent on the leader of the institution. The institution is built by active participation of all the stakeholders, and I believe in growing together, not in growing alone. I try to involve all the stakeholders in the decision making. That is my philosophy of working. I do have faith in my colleagues, and it should be any administrator should have faith in his or her colleagues. Then and only then the institution will work together and the institution will grow. And as far as running an institution is concerned, after all it's a teamwork. So if it is a case of bringing laurels to the institution, I feel the credit goes to all stakeholders. And if in case of some failures are there in the name of the institution, then I think that will be a credit of mine alone, because I will be solely responsible for the failures. But if we are going to share the happiness, we are going to share the laurels, then it's credit of all the stakeholders of the institution. That is what I feel.
So it is one of the qualities of the great leaders, that whenever the failure comes, it is taken solely upon them, and whenever you are doing anything good, the greatness which your team has done, you share it among yourselves.
Yes.
So, it is a great philosophy, sir. Coming to the next question, sir, how do you strategize about the key programs and marketing of the school?
As far as the marketing of the school is concerned, as you also know, the Shivaji Science College Nagpur has been itself a brand in itself, and as we all know that the founding society, Sri Shivaji Education Society Amravati, which was founded by Dr. Panjabrao Alais Bhausaheb Deshmukh, the first Union Agriculture Minister of India, led by the government of Pandit Jawaharlal Ji Nehru, The Dr. Panjabrao Deshmukh was a great philosopher, educationist, agriculturist, and in 1932 he established this Sri Shivaji Education Society for the benefit of the poor farmers, for the benefit of the downtrodden society, so that the students, so that the wards of the farmers can get education, proper education. And you will be surprised to know that our Sri Shivaji Education Society is the second largest society in entire Maharashtra, which runs more than 300 plus schools and colleges. So we feel very proud and pride in being associated with this Sri Shivaji Education Society. Now, as far as your question is concerned, so with the blessings of Dr. Bhausaheb Deshmukh and with the hard work of our former colleagues in this institution, as such, we need not have to advertise our institution. As I have already said, Shivaji has itself become a brand in education fraternity in Central India.
Okay, so coming to the next question, how does the curriculum of Shivaji Science College ensure the best practice of the industry?
As you know, this Shivaji Science College is affiliated with the Rashtrasant Tukaraji Maharaj Nagpur University. And as being an affiliated institution of the university, the curriculum of the courses which are run in our college are prepared by the Board of Studies, comprising of various academicians at the university level. So as such, we do not have any flexibility for framing our own syllabus. But what we do is we follow the syllabus structure provided by the university, by the Board of Studies of the respective subjects.
Sir, you mentioned that you do not have an power to like change the curriculum of the academic curriculum.
But still, few of the faculty members from our institutes are in the Board of Studies, and they accordingly make corrections, additions, or improvement in the Board of Studies of their respective syllabus.
Okay, so sir, how does Shivaji Science College ensure that the overall growth of the student is maintained? Like, not only the academic curriculum, but you do not have any bar on like fixing the extra academic curriculum. So how do you fix that? Like, are there any activities conducted by the school so that the students' personality development is?
Yes. Shivaji is not only known for academics. Shivaji is also promoting all the extracurricular activities for the benefit of the students. We do groom our students from extracurricular activities ranging from social activities. We do have NSS unit, National Service Scheme unit, and for your information, I am very happy to share with you that during the COVID-19 pandemic, we do have also NCC unit of girls. During the COVID-19 pandemic, our students of NSS and NCC took active participation in assisting the district administration for the volunteering during COVID-19 pandemic. Many of our students were working at the ration shops for distributing the food to the needy, and we feel very proud of our students that the students not only excel in academics, but they also excel in all walks of life, may it be social activities, may it be national activities, and so on.
It is great to hear that, sir. Like, in such a big institution is trying all its heart to like help and give back to the society through their students. Yes. So you mentioned about COVID-19. So how has COVID-19 affected the working of the institution?
As far as COVID-19 pandemic is concerned, as we all know, the colleges and schools are shut down since nearly 18 months. But at our institute, and like other institutions, the teaching learning process has never stopped. The teaching learning process is ongoing, and I am very happy to share with you that during this pandemic period, our institution conducted online classes for all the courses, and we feel proud that the online platform was developed by our own society. The learning management system and the classes were conducted on that learning management system, which was developed by our own education society, Sri Shivaji Education Society. And during this pandemic period, under the leadership of our Honorable President of Sri Shivaji Education Society, Sri Harshavardhan Ji Deshmukh, throughout our society, that means 300 plus schools and colleges, the online coaching, online teaching learning was followed from primary schools to the PG courses on the learning management system provided by the Sri Shivaji Education Society.
So coming to the next question, sir, when you first came to Shivaji Science College in Nagpur, what was your vision for the college and how has it evolved over time and how far have you come in implementing the vision that you made when you first came?
When I firstly joined this institution in 1996, then I was merely 24. I had just completed my post graduation. And you won't believe, it was the first time I come from Amravati. It was the first time when I visited Nagpur for the interview of a lecturer in this particular institution. When I joined this institution, I was very much scared whether I will be able to cope up with the
requirements of the college.
Very famous institution and the students here at, and by the way, Amravati is a smaller town as compared to Nagpur, but I was very confident that I will do it, and accordingly I served here for almost 17-18 years. After serving almost 17-18 years, I shifted to Rashtra Sant Tukdoji Maharaj Nagpur University Computer Science Department as Associate Professor. After staying there for 5.5 years, I again got recruited as a principal of this prestigious Shivaji Science College in April 19. So I take the reins of principal of this college on 25th April 2019.
Okay, so sir, what would you like people to know about the Shivaji Science College that they may not know through some other sources or some other platforms?
So, in this regard, I would like to say that this college is not only known for academics, it is known for other activities. For example, we do have international level players at our college. You must have heard of Malvika Bansod. Malvika Bansod is our alumni. She has represented many international badminton tournaments. Yes, and likewise, we do have a galaxy of our sports persons, what we call academicians, doctors. We do have a great alumni base wherein our alumni are scattered throughout the globe and they are working at very good positions. Now, as far as academic is concerned, we not only concentrate on academics, but we concentrate on the all-round development of the students. We give every opportunity for extracurricular activities to the students. We also promote participation of students in each and every activity which is needed as per the societal benefit. That means in participation, we promote participation in social activities so that our students become good citizens of the great India.
Okay, that's great to hear that. Coming to the next question, could you give us some insight about how the Shivaji Science College is helping students to get the placements and how is the placement scenario for the college?
We do have an active placement cell. As far as the placements of the students of UG are concerned, as we run BSc biotechnology, BSc microbiology. We also run a BSc computer science. We also have a specialized course, BCA, Bachelor in Computer Applications. And every year, many companies come to visit our college for campus recruitment, and many of the students, being the extraordinary students, they get placed in campus recruitment. But the part is that when the students get selected for the campus recruitment, but their main intention is to pursue post-graduation. So, for example, if 20 students have been shortlisted by some of the companies, not only all the 20 students join the company because many of them wish to go for higher education. And similarly, in case of post-graduation, we do have MCA course, we do have MSc Computer Science, MSc Chemistry, MSc Microbiology, MSc Mathematics, MSc Physics. So, being a vibrant placement cell at our college, our placement team works hard for the placement of the students. They work hard for the grooming of the students to make them employable also. We regularly conduct personality development events. We regularly conduct interview skilling seminars for the benefit of the students, and obviously the students get benefit out of that.
So it is great to hear that such a great institution is helping students and craving the way for the students so that they can pursue and give the, whatever is required in the interview or in the tests that are taken for the interview process. So coming to the last but not the least question, any suggestions that you would like to give to the current youth and aspiring students?
Suggestion in respect of students, you mean to say? Yeah.
Yes.
So nowadays I feel the biggest challenge we academicians face is the students' attitude. What I think is students are lacking the belongingness. The student should feel that this is my college, this is my teacher, this is my classroom, this is my environment, and so there should be a sense of belongingness among the students, and so also the sense of possessiveness is a must for a student, for a student of any institution. The day when this sense of belongingness and possessiveness is there in any of the student, obviously the institution is going to do miracles, wonders. As far as suggestions are concerned, I feel that we should live in a realistic world. The students should know their strengths, their weaknesses, and above all, one should be honest with himself or herself. And that will lead to a good citizenship or good and responsible citizen of India. And obviously, all these will contribute to the nation building of our country. So, this is all what I feel for the young generation that they should work on. Thank you.
Thank you so much, sir. Being honest with himself or herself is one of the things that I think every dignitary from all over India that I have met or talked to has taken this issue. And we are genuinely facing the students' attitude that they have towards academics is not very correct as it was about 5 years or 10 years ago. So I feel that this is something we as a nation should improve, and if we can do something on that part, it will be great for the nation to grow, and so that the students are focused towards their academic and they are looking forward to something in their life. Thank you so much, sir, for taking out your time, accepting our invitation at such a short notice. Thank you so much.
Thank you. Thank you very much. Thank you, Harsh.